Hi folks, welcome back again this week. We get to the second church of Smyrna in the book of Revelation. And what do we find? Well, we find blessing, we find curse, we find... come on, Ed. My mind has a tendency of slipping away sometimes. We have a punishment, we have a reward, and we have a praise. Something we do because the second spirit from Smyrna dwells in us. What is the second spirit of God of the seven? What is number two? Well, we know what the seven are, and we know that grace is number one. And if we read our Bibles and we study, we find that we can pick out of that seven the spirit of truth. Now, some people might say, well, the spirit of truth is love. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'll go along with that. I'll also say that God is spirit, and the spirit we call God is truth. So the spirit of truth, or the spirit we identify as truth, would it not reflect love for God first and foremost? See, no matter which way you want to look at it, would it not reflect the love of God first and foremost? The answer is yes. What's the first and greatest command? Love God. Of the Ten Commandments, half of them, the first half of them, are all talking about God. And the second half are talking about loving your neighbor as yourself. What's the second command? That's like the first. Well, love your neighbor. Love God and love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus himself told us that. The Old Testament tells us that over and over and over. I couldn't count the number of times the Old Testament reiterates that love God and love your neighbor as yourself. If you love God, wouldn't you search for him? Wouldn't you? He says, if you search, you'll find. And if you search and you find, wouldn't you call him by name? This second spirit, the spirit of truth, reveals something very interesting. It reveals the identity of God. Remember? The first and the last. The everlasting Father. The first and the last. Old Testament. Who was dead. And behold, is alive forever and ever and holds the keys to death and Hades. New Testament. What's his name? It's Jesus. It's Jesus. So now over here, we've got two of the sevenfold Spirit of God, or the seven spirits of God that surround his throne. We got two of them. We've got grace, the spirit of grace, operating in us. This is the God. This seven, this is the God that we serve. His name is Jesus. Remember, you got someone standing in the middle, and then you got the four living creatures, and then you got the sevenfold Spirit of God. I'm showing you the sanctuary. We do our best to let the grace of God in here. But now we've got something even more, don't we? We know who God is. We begin to understand that, wow, when Jesus said, love God and love your neighbor, maybe we should really pay close attention to that and obey him. And so now we have the Spirit of truth in us as well. And we have the Spirit who is truth. His name is Jesus. This is our confession. This is what saves us. And that's something. It's not what you believe that saves you. It's what you confess. So now we got two. But wait a minute, over here on the left, there's a seven-headed beast. The whore rides this beast's back. This is what carries the whore. No grace. No truth. What does this one say? Jesus is not God the Father. Don't be ridiculous, Ed. Jesus is not God. Jesus was a man, if he even existed at all. And I'm a man too. I'm God. Listen to what I tell you, Ed. Don't listen to that crummy, perverted Bible of yours. Don't listen to that. No, no, no. Listen to what I got to tell you. Really? Get behind me, Satan. You have not in mind the things of God. You only have in mind the things of man. You think your opinion matters. Well, guess what? It don't mean shit. It doesn't matter one bit. Your opinion will only condemn you. But if you listen to the mighty counselor, speak from his word, God will reveal himself to you. And you'll make a choice. You'll make a choice of whether you want to follow the sevenfold Spirit of God, or whether you want to ride the beast. I know a lot of whores. Wow, do I know a lot of whores. Seven spirits of God. Seven heads of the beast. The beast is the dragon, and the dragon is falsehood, the devil. What's the third? Well, I'm going to speed it up now a little bit for you. Spirit of grace, the spirit of truth. If Jesus is Lord, and Jesus commanded us to love even our enemies, and to love God, our confession then now is Jesus is Lord, and our behavior, our actions led by that which we consider to be divine. He is God. We do our best to love one another. Okay. Do we not take him seriously then? Do you think it's wise to bite the hand that feeds you? Do you think it's wise to, how would you say, rebel against he who is the authority? Who is the king? King's wrath could break out in an instant, boy. The king loves all right. Your mom and dad loved you. But when you misbehaved, you got the spanking. Didn't mean they didn't love you. Mean they discipline you. You not fear God's discipline? Is not the third of the sevenfold spirit of God? Is not the third spirit this knowledge of grace and truth leading you to the fear of the Lord? Yep. Here it comes. No grace, no truth, no fear of the Lord. Why should I fear God? There is no God. I'm God. I don't have to care about you. I'm not your keeper. You see the third head of the beast? How about the fourth spirit of God? Wisdom and understanding. The spirit of God. Wisdom and understanding. It's the fourth church of Thyatira. It's what it's telling us. It's what it's explaining to us. So our wisdom and understanding, where does it come from? Well, it comes from the tree of life, doesn't it? What's the fourth head of the beast? Remember? It's exactly the opposite of this one. What's the fourth head? What's the opposite of wisdom and understanding? Foolishness and ignorance. What's this head say?
I am wise. I have my knowledge of good and evil. What do I need the tree of life for? I got it all figured out. Listen to me, I'll teach you.
Really? Really? You see the fourth head of the beast? You see it? It's exactly the opposite to the fourth spirit of God. It's 180 degrees opposed. Well, this one's wisdom and understanding. What's the fifth? What's the spirit of judgment? We're not supposed to judge, Ed.
Really? Who told you that? Are we not supposed to judge those within the house?
Within the church? Don't bother judging those outside the house. Leave them to God. He'll judge them. Judge those in the house.
I didn't write this shit. It's right here.
The spirit of judgment. What do we base our judgment on? Grace. Truth. Fear of the Lord? Wisdom and understanding? You know what comes with wisdom and understanding, eh? Do you remember? I told you right at the beginning, way back. The spirit of prophecy. With wisdom and understanding, you start figuring out what it says in this book. You start realizing what the prophets are telling us. You start understanding what's going on out there right now. That you don't have to be afraid. God's in charge. He explained it all to us. Remember I told you one time, locusts, their ideas? There's young locusts, there's the locust swarm. Many ideas to one intent. God told us. He punished Pharaoh with the locust, but the locust didn't harm the Israelites. Didn't eat their crop. But the locust sure consumed everything green and growing in Egypt. In the same way as today, the locusts, that locust swarm that's come, is consuming everything that's green and growing. It's not growing. Something is not growing in the way that God desires it to grow when it's becoming more and more wicked. When chaos is expanding big time. That's the growth of chaos. Yes, I admit that. But that's not what the Bible's talking about when it says green and growing. A society is going backwards, not forwards. It has to be going forwards to be green and growing. It's going backwards when chaos takes over. A society is not growing when chaos takes over. It's going backwards. Civilization is being destroyed. Everything that God has planted is being destroyed. The gospel. Nobody listens to the gospel. People don't even want to talk about the gospel. I've only got a couple of people on the whole internet that I can find who want to talk about the gospel that reveals Jesus as Lord. It's not even out there anymore. Oh, we're the church and we're all going to whine and pity ourselves in our little corners and we're all going to run and hide and we're not going to say anything because we're afraid. Don't mention the Lord. Don't mention the Lord's name. It'll just get us into trouble. What a bunch. What a bunch. They're ashamed of their God. Can you imagine that? Claim you love God and you're ashamed of Him? You're not fit to carry the sword. You're ashamed of it. You're afraid to fight. You're afraid to stand up in battle and defend. You say, oh, we're not supposed to argue, Ed. We're not supposed to argue. Well, what the hell? How do you think God worked it out? How did Jesus work it out? You don't think Jesus argued with the Pharisees and the teachers of the law and the Sadducees? He argued with them every day. Read the book, for crying out loud. Listen to what it's telling you. I don't want to harm anybody. Lots of people, they just don't have it in them to say much. But I'll tell you, you better say enough. You better say enough. And you better not be so ashamed that you won't even admit that Jesus is the God you serve. That Jesus is God the Father Himself in His one and only ever begotten bodily form. You better not be ashamed of that. Because if you're ashamed of that, God will be ashamed of you. And you'll be treading on very thin ice. And the water's deep underneath that ice. So we've got the spirit of grace. No grace. We got the spirit of truth. No truth. We got this knowledge of grace and truth leading us to the fear of the Lord. Not afraid of the Lord over here. We got the spirit of wisdom and understanding from the tree of life. Screw your tree of life. Who needs that? I got the knowledge of good and evil. I am just like God. We got the spirit of judgment. Based upon what God says, what God wants.
Oh, we got the spirit of judgment all right, but it's the judgment of man against man. Because man thinks he's God, remember? Number two. Man has no grace, so man judges any way he wants. You walk into a situation. Somebody wants to argue. They get up in your face a bit, you know. And the old man inside tries to rise up. The devil tries to get a claw in there, you know. Open it up a little bit. Get in his face, Ed. Get on him, too. Oh, you want to push me? I can push you. You want to fight? I know how to fight. Be careful when you're driving out demons. Those demons don't get into you. Yeah, that's from the Bible. No shit. Yeah. Be careful. Because what God do you serve? Or do you want to take a joyride on the beast? Be careful. There's two left, isn't there? Number six is the spirit of counsel and power. Does your counsel and power come from the seven? From God's Holy Spirit? Yeah, His Holy Spirit. It's not an emotional stimulation. It's not what you want. It's what God wants. What's the opposite of number six? Six is the spirit of counsel and power. What's the opposite? 180 degrees opposed. Well, our counsel and power is based on the tree of life. The beast's counsel and power is based on the knowledge of good and evil. So what's he going to preach? Break out your arms, boys! We're going to war! Kill the mother! Beat the shit out of them! Tell him the truth. He's an effing asshole.
What boat do you want to sail in? You want to sit on the throne? Or you want to ride the beast? I've shown you what the beast is now, haven't I? I truly have. What's the seventh spirit of God? It's the spirit of fire. It's the spirit of fire. And what does God say? My word. My word. Not your word, Ed. My word. Out of your mouth will be the fire that consumes everything. Wow. The fire of God. What's it based upon? Grace and truth and the fear of the Lord with wisdom and understanding, making proper judgments, giving proper counsel and power. The power of God's the gospel that reveals the identity of God as Jesus. That is the power of God. What are you preaching, Ed? Are you all concerned about all this shit that's going on out in the world today? And it is, it's going on everywhere. Every nation is tasting of it. The locust swarm, it's a horde. It's everywhere. It's touching everyone everywhere.
Is it doing harm to you? Is it getting you to want to ride the beast? Become the beast? Become the great whore? Mystery Babylon? Let's put men in chains? They don't deserve to be called Canadians. Or they deserve what they get. That may be true, but are you going to participate in it? Or are you going to stand on the throne with God? It's your choice. It's your choice. Be wise. Make the right choice. Yes, we see it, but we understand what's going on. God's at work, and God's in charge. And as long as we stick with our Lord, and as long as we continue to obey His command, no matter what, we will see eternal life. Of this I guarantee. These ones will not. Because climbing on the back of this beast marks you for destruction. No, it's not a tattoo. No, it's not a computer chip. Riding this beast makes you a whore. And it marks you for destruction. Be wise. Ride with me. Ride with the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Keep that so close that no one take it from you. It's your choice. You're not God's little slave. You're not God's bitch. I shouldn't even use that word, slave. You're not God's bitch. You're not His robot. He didn't program you to be saved from the beginning of time, before you were even in your daddy's shorts. He didn't program you specifically to be saved. He gave you choice. He gave me choice. And He put me here. And He put you here. And He says, choose. What God you want to serve. Choose wisely. Is it hard? Yeah. I didn't say it was easy. Neither did God. This mortal realm is our punishment. It's not the Garden of Eden. It's not paradise. It's our punishment, having to be in a world where the beast roams and the whore rides him and keeps him alive. I can take the whole Ten Commandments and show you the opposite. So can you. If you know this, you can look at the Ten Commandments and see the ten horns. And just look at all the opposites. Thou shalt not kill. Kill. Over here, thou shalt not kill. Over here, kill. Thou shalt not lie. Over here, lie your teeth out. Make shit up. Start a rumor. Get the gossip mill going. We'll get them. Thou shalt not steal.
not even another person's dignity. Don't rob temples. That's what it says here. Don't rob temples. Over here? Now take what I want. I don't care what you think. You're a worthless piece of shit. Why should I worry about you? Hey. Pick your fruit. You can't eat of both. You can't eat of the tree of life and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil and expect to live. You will die. God didn't lie. The day you eat of this shit, you will die eternally. Don't mark yourself with this crap, folks. Don't. Walk with the Lord. Get up here on this path. Get up here. You'll walk through life and you will look at shit on the right and shit on the left. And it won't get up on this path. It won't. Don't jump off the path to go ride the dragon. Oh, it just... No, don't do that. Please, I beg you, don't do that. Walk with the Lord. Always. In thick and thin. In good times and bad, in health and in sickness, till death, and he will give you life. Because if you stick with him, you're his bride to be. She's not. She's an adulterous prostitute. She's on her way to the lake of fire. Period. Walk with the Lord. Lord willing, we'll see you again next week. I love you all. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Bye for now.